Hello everyone, today we will discuss what is internet and what are its components. So let us start. Internet is a place where we go for information, entertainment or to communicate with people using smartphones, laptops or tablets. In the most basic form, two computers connected to each other via wired or wireless connection, sharing data with each other forms a network or computer network. Internet is the world's largest computer network, consisting of millions of interconnected computers located in hundreds of countries. Right now, you are watching this video on YouTube, so it means your computer is also connected to the internet. But is your computer a part of the internet? Yes, it is. We call them as hosts or end systems. So your computer is one of the parts of the internet. But what are the other parts of the internet? Let us discuss it now. At the edge of the internet, we have devices which we use to connect to the internet. For example, personal computers, servers, data centers, smartphones, security cameras, smart TVs, smart watches, or vehicles. We call these devices as hosts or end systems. So end systems are present at the edge of the internet. If we move deeper, we will find devices which forward data among each other and end systems. We call them as packet switches. There are two types of packet switches, routers and link layer switches. End systems, routers and link layer switches are connected to each other via communication links. So, the parts or components of the internet are end systems, routers, link layer switches and communication links. Collection of end systems, routers, link layer switches, and communication links forms a network. Now, if I want to watch a video on YouTube, my network should be connected to the content provider network or YouTube network. In other words, both networks should be connected to the internet. The internet connection is provided by national or local internet service providers or ISPs. Internet is all about connecting end systems. So, internet service providers are also connected to each other. This forms an interconnected network or internet. So, we can say that internet is a network of networks. In a smartphone, there are multiple applications which we use to stream music, videos, or to send messages. These applications are called distributed applications because they involve multiple end systems that exchange data with each other. To make these applications work, the internet provides an interface that these applications can use to send or receive the information. So we can say that internet is an infrastructure that provides services to the applications. If one person is sending a message to another person, then his message is divided into small units called packets, which are reassembled at the destination end system to display the correct message. Internet is only concerned with the delivery of packets of information. Conversion of packets into text, images, or videos is done by the applications installed on a computer. All communication activities in the internet are governed by protocols. What are protocols? Protocols are a set of rules that describe a standard way of doing things on the internet so that devices can communicate with each other. For example, TCP, IP, HTTP protocols. The body that defines these standards for the internet is Internet Engineering Task Force, and their standards are called Request for Comments or RFCs. So this is internet which we use in our day-to-day life. If you have learned something from this video, then please like this video. Share this video so that more people can learn. Subscribe to TechTerms if you want to learn more and turn the notification icon on. Thanks for watching.